fucking god! Time for a new vlog! How the fuck are we doing today, guys? Today, we're doing very, very awesome and sexy. Today is a very awesome and sexy Elf City Monday. Yes! The legendary Elf City that we have been waiting for about, let's see. Has it really been about 8 years? Well, I've been waiting since, I'd say maybe about 2.5 hours ago, since I completed Plague's End. Some people on this game, they completed fucking, what was the damn quest? Within the Light, like maybe years ago and shit, and then they've been waiting ever since for the legendary Elf City. However, my little friends out there, well, we no longer have to wait because it is here, and I had to wait very, very short-ass period. So if you haven't done, well, firstly, if you want to see the Elf City in a full walkthrough of a video, it is uploaded on me little channel of Happy Happy Bum Bum Joy and shit. I actually just fucking forgot to do something. Forgot to add fucking link in my little video linking you guys to the YouTuber that I used his guides for, The Complete RS. If you guys would like to, well, do Plague's End, Plague City, all the plagues questing in general, check out his channel, The Complete RS. It's pretty fucking good skill guides. But besides that, quest guides. God damn it, my brain. Yes, anyways, haven't vlogged in a couple days, ever since, 12-hour KK Mass and the 99 Little Slayer Party, which was, Saturday. Kinda felt like it was last week, but it was only like a day and a half ago. Anyways, yesterday uploaded what we made from the KK. What we made from the KK, it was absolute shit. Beyond shit. It was, the biggest form of shit on the planet. However, not this coming weekend, because I'm going to be busy, but the following weekend, I'm going to be doing a 12-hour, next little mass. So, it's going to be a little different, and hopefully next is more promising than butt-fucking KK. That kind of really sucks. But then again, the shards, it's really all about the shards. I mean, the shards are deceivers. However, the KK drop ratio is 1 out of 80. Next drop is 1 out of 35. Not to mention, when you go to next, you can actually make some money. Because it drops 800k in coal, dehydes, 800k in herbs. Fucking KK, it drops snapdragon seeds that are like 20k. What the fuck, Jagex? Seriously? And it drops like 50 sharks. Okay, I understand we're using a lot of food, but seriously, come on now. There's no reason to be a little wiener. Anyways, on the virtual bung board, as you see, we're actually going to be getting 117 Dungeoneering tonight, which is going to be fucking very sexy and very awesome in general. Not to mention, we are going to be getting summoning little EXP up as well. As you see, summoning has now replaced my Slayer little doodad. Because we no longer are putting Jackatrades into Slayer, we are now putting Jackatrades into summoning, which probably most likely will be 87 summoning relatively soon, maybe like tomorrow. Not tomorrow. Depending if we get another daily task. However, that is what we're using Jackatrades on right now, my friends, which is very awesome and very fucking sexy indeed. Oh, yes it is! Oh, my balls of tingly joy! Oh, god damn it. Not to mention, it just feels awesome doing quests that are actually fun, because I did have fun doing Plague's End, and I did actually unlock a lot of places on this damn game that normally you don't really see that you go to unless you do a whole bunch of quests. But, that is the new dealio of Jagex. Alright, so anyways, besides that, we're going to be talking about the demoralization. Should I use that word, moralization, demeaning, depowering, de-circumference of a circumcised penis? The radius of a uterus, some ovaries. Ah, we're throwing some nasty syphilis as well. So we're going to be talking about skill capes having less of a meaning than they already are. If you complete Plague's Inn, the reward is Elf City. Yes, it is a wonderful reward. Now, in order to do Plague's Inn, there's really only a handful of requirements. It's not like fucking while Guthic sleeps that you need 270 quest points. I believe it's 270 quest points. Yep, 270. Oh, fuck that quest. I don't think I'm ever going to do while Guthic sleeps on this game. However, I did say that for, Mourner's End Part 2 and 1 and all the other horrible things. However, the only quest that we really have left to do for the time being that I think that I'm going to retire my questing happy ball sack is going to actually be Edgar's Ruse, because I want to unlock God Wars Teleport. And, wait a second, nope, that's all. Just that fucking quest in general. Just one more quest, then we'll be done questing just the whole shish kebab and stuff like that. Anyways, if you do Plague's Inn, which, like I said, there's no real requirements, just you have to do Mourner's Inn 1, 2, a whole bunch of other quests, Plague City, Biohazard, Within the Light, etc., etc., not die, and, kill a boss at the end of Plague's Inn, which is pretty goddamn easy, especially if you're, a high combat with overloads and fucking Armadale and Chaotic Crossbows, it becomes pretty easy. However, thing about it is that, the reward is, it's virtually, you have mining of literally about 100 and, what is it for mining? It's about 120k EXP an hour of mining, not to mention, out of fucking smithing, it's about 120k EXP an hour. I mean, I remember doing mining at Living Rock Hole fucking caverns, even though I really shouldn't talk, because there are people that did mining by dropping iron ore back when there was no living asshole rock caverns. However, I did Living Rock Hole caverns. I got hit by a whole bunch of cock-knocking asshole rock people, and it sucked. It was the biggest form of shittiest things on this game ever. However, I still fucking did it. It sucked major balls, and it was horrible. Then for smithing, I did 200,000 gold bars, or I smelted 2,000 gold ores into gold bars. Now, you don't have to literally do any of that. All you have to do is AFK mining, AFK smithing. It's the easiest fucking thing to do on the planet. It really is. However, you don't make any money from it. I'm almost positive you don't make any money from it, because you're using corrupt ore and you're using the corrupt little bars, which don't really turn into bars. So you're not making a profit. However, if you do want to make a profit, you go to Living Asshole Rock Caverns, you get like 70,000k EXP an hour versus 120k. However, you do make, some decent amount of money. Living Rock Caverns, I think you can make like 400 or 500k an hour. Maybe like 400k an hour is what I used to make, so you could probably most likely make the same, considering gold ore is probably still like 350, 360 GP-ish. Probably most likely rising right now, but still. A lot of the caves, they kind of really go down in value, which is one of the reasons why I don't want to get Runecrafting Cape. Because a little Runecrafting Cape has no meaning. It's not like I made 200,000 little nature runes and made a fuck ton of money. It has no meaning, goddammit. There is no meaning of RuneSpan. You sit at RuneSpan. You click on a whole bunch of little runes. Then you click on a whole bunch of other little shit. And the cape has no meaning. And you get like 65k EXP an hour. However, now the mining cape and smithing cape, it's one of those things that it has really no more meaning. But if you're not like me, and if you chose to wait, oh yes, and there's a there's a gigantic fucking bonfire at the place also. So, well, fire making cape already went down. I was 95 fire making back in 2008, and pretty much the Inferno little maze came out where you can get the Inferno gloves for fire making. And I pretty much said, fuck it, I'm just gonna continue lighting my logs in the ground. Then 3 years later, bonfires came out, and whoop, it's a doozy. However, yeah, some capes in this game definitely goes down in value. But, once again, you do have to do a lot of reward. It's, well, you have to do a lot of quests to actually get into play, to get into the Elf City little land of the titties. And it's pronounced Perthesis or something like that. Reminds me of Prometheus, but Prometheus is such a well better movie and stuff. however, overall, if you get into the land of the titties, like I said, the rewards are actually pretty good. You can get Bonfire EXP, Smithing EXP, Mining EXP. Soon they're going to make a Smithing Obelisk in Part 2 of the city. And that's a funny thing. They're only releasing Part 1 of fucking Elf City. What the fuck? Seriously. I mean, there's only Part 1 of the Elf City. And now they're going to make Part 2, which is probably going to be like 10 years from now. But, oh well. It's a way for them to keep people addicted to this game. Overall, basically, from this video, like I said, the mining cape has gone down a little in value. But then again, if you're racing to 99 and racing to a completionist cape, your job kinda just got a little easier. Alright guys, by the way, tonight we're gonna be doing some more live streaming, in general. We'll be doing some, tonight we may do some God Wars, might actually take care of that one fucking quest on RuneScape that I need to take care of, Edgar's Ruse. Not really sure how long that quest is gonna take. Quest might take a little poop titty or something. Hopefully it's it won't take fucking forever and shit. However, overall, like I said, looking forward to see some of you guys on live streaming and shit. Our money cash stack is actually going up, which is it's a good one, and it's yes, it definitely is. But anyways, besides goals on RuneScape and other random crapola, right now I want you to go to my email address and read off some happy, happy, hooba hooba questions from you motherfuckers. Ask nightmarehyahoo.com. Do not drink too many use, because if you do, well, my friends, you will certainly get bum-fucked and all your skill capes will go down in value. Then it would just be horrible, 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 horrible little thingies in the sky. Anyways, first woohoo question. Woo! Hey, Nightmare, love the vids. I was wondering, what is the best way to motivate yourself to get your first chaotic weapon? Also, which method is the best way to get the most tokens? I find dung so damn boring and tedious, but I really want a chaotic weapon. Thanks for reading. Arsu's name, Yensite, I think that's how you pronounce that name. Best way to stay motivated is, don't kill your computer. That's the easiest and best way. However, overall, one way that you can actually get the fastest tokens is by doing 5-man dungeons. Yes, I know Dungeoneering World fucking sucks balls and people leave all the time. However, you can try Dungeoneering with friends if you have any on RuneScape, or if your friends list is just made up of robots. You could possibly just, Dungeoneering 5-man teams, doing smalls, then once you unlock abandoned floors, start doing larges, and then reset and keep doing it over and over and over again. And then soon you'll be able to get your chaotic weapon at 80 mil, it's 80, level 80, which is 2 mil EXP and shit like that. Otherwise, hope you say, oh yes, and if you're gonna solo Dungeoneer, well then solo Dungeoneer, you need a lot of motivation. I would say probably most likely, don't fucking run into walls. otherwise, if you're gonna solo Dungeoneer, then make sure to listen to music and, who the fuck solo Dungeoneers? Never solo Dungeoneer, goddammit, you lose EXP out the ass. Always Dungeoneer in 5-man teams, which, right now on RuneScape, there are tons of people Dungeoneering, and bonus EXP weekend, there's gonna be more people as well. It's gonna be shitty because it's not gonna be bonus tokens, but who really cares? Anyways, guys, let me know some nasty, dirty little comments if you're able to get into the land of the titties. If not, well, shit on me balls. Otherwise, I'll see you guys later. Bye!